हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस द लॉ ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड इन दैट द एसेंशियल्स ऑफ वैलिड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट। नाउ अंडर द इंडियन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट, द बेसिकली इंडियन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक्ट इज डिवाइडेड बिटवीन टू पार्ट्स। सेक्शन 1 to 75 डील्स विद द जनरल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड फ्रॉम सेक्शन 124 टू सेक्शन 238 that deals with the special contracts. And today in this lecture we'll see what are the essentials of a valid contract. Contract basically gives rise to rights and obligations between the contracting parties, and when they are trying to enforce the rights and obligations against each other, there is a need that such particular agreement should be recognized validly under the principles of the contract or the law of contract. And so today we'll discuss what are the essentials to make such particular transaction as a contract or valid contract. Let's begin with the essentials of a valid contract. Now in this, first let us see the definition of contract. So section 2H of the Indian Contract Act, which says that an agreement enforceable by law is a contract. And so we have to understand the agreement and the enforceable by law. These are the two values we understand in this definition which provided under section 2H. Enforceable by law we'll see later on, but first let's see how there is a formation of agreement taken place. So first, what is agreement? Section 2E of the Indian Contract Act, which provides that every promise and every set of promise forming consideration for each other is called as an agreement. So in this definition there is a concept of promise, and promise along with the consideration leads to the formation of agreement. So when we say there is a formation of promise, there is a need to understand the proposal. Until and unless we are not understanding the proposal, we can't understand the formation of promise. And so when we ask a question, how promise forms, we'll see the answer in the concept of proposal. When the person to whom the proposal is made signifies his assent, then the proposal is said to be accepted, and such accepted proposal is a promise. And so proposal is nothing but when one person signifies to another his willingness to do or abstain from doing with a view to obtain the assent of that another, then we can say the person is making a proposal to that another. And so when proposal is made and such proposal is accepted by that another person, there is a formation of promise. So proposal and acceptance to that proposal, that forms a promise. And with this we can understand that the very starting point of a contract is nothing but the proposal. Then the acceptance of that proposal, that accepted proposal convert into a promise. When that promise is coupled with or along with the consideration determines, then we can say there is actually the formation of agreement. So in this stages we reach to the agreement. Now the second particular point of a definition of contract, that is enforceable by law. And so which agreements can be enforceable by law? To answer this question we have to see section 10 of the Indian Contract Act. All agreements are contract if they are made by free consent of parties competent to contract for a lawful consideration and with a lawful object, and such agreement shall not be expressly declared to be void. So these are the very essentials of valid contract, what we are understanding from section 10 of the Indian Contract Act. तो वो सारे एग्रीमेंट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट है, अगर वो एग्रीमेंट फ्री कंसेंट ऑफ पार्टी से किए जाते हैं, जो पार्टीज़ उस एग्रीमेंट में आती है वो कॉम्पिटेंट पार्टीज़ है, एग्रीमेंट जो किया जा रहा है वो लॉफुल कंसिडरेशन के लिए किया जा रहा है, लॉफुल ऑब्जेक्ट के लिए किया जा रहा है, एंड सच एग्रीमेंट आर नॉट हेयर बाय एक्सप्रेसली डिक्लेयर टू बी वॉइड. सो इन सेक्शन 10 इटसेल्फ we are finding the essentials of a valid contract, and so section 10 is nothing but the touchstone test for such particular agreements which can be converted into a contract if they are complying, if they are fulfilling the very criteria, the very factors, indicators given by section 10 of the Indian Contract Act. Now here we are understanding the essentials of a valid contract. तो कौन से essentials है जिससे हम वो contract को valid contract understand करते हैं? तो इसमें पहला है proposal and acceptance, दूसरा है legal relationship, तीसरा है lawful consideration, fourth है competency of party, fifth है free consent, sixth है lawful object, and then seventh है not expressly declared to be void. Now in this first we understand what is proposal, what is acceptance. So valid offer or promise must be made by an offerer, and valid acceptance of such offer by promise by acceptor makes the agreement. So offer पहले offerer देगा, वो offer valid होनी चाहिए. इसका मतलब ऑफर मस्ट बी मेड एक्सप्रेसली और इम्प्लाइडली, कम्युनिकेशन होना चाहिए, ऑफर से देयर मस्ट बी द इंटेंशन टू क्रिएट अ लीगल रिलेशनशिप. तो ये सारे पॉइंट्स वहाँ पे इन दैट ऑफर होने चाहिए. इन द सेम मैनर वैलिड एक्सेप्टेंस टू दैट ऑफर वो भी देना चाहिए. सो वंस वैलिड एक्सेप्टेंस इज गिवन टू द दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑफर, that makes a promise, and when promise is given that converts that particular promise or that formation of promise leads to the agreement in between the parties. And so proposal and acceptance, that is one of the essential of a valid contract. Second essential, that is a legal relationship. तो दो पार्टी जब कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में आती है, बोथ द पार्टीज मस्ट इंटेंड टू क्रिएट अ लीगल रिलेशनशिप. सो डोमेस्टिक और सोशल रिलेशंस विल नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज अंडर अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, एंड सो व्हेन पार्टीज दे आर इंटेंडिंग टू क्रिएट अ लीगल रिलेशनशिप, देन ओनली दे कैन इम्पोज अ लीगल ऑब्लिगेशन, एंड देन दैट लीगल ऑब्लिगेशन एक्चुअली कॉन्स्टिट्यूट द एग्रीमेंट. And in this regard, Balfour versus Balfour, one of the landmark judgment you can refer. And so the parties, they are coming into the agreement or in the transaction with intent to create a legal relationship. They are not coming with a intent to maintaining some domestic or social relations. जैसे friend ने दूसरे friend को dinner के लिए invite किया, and if suppose that friend is not attended that dinner, and so for the unconsumed food that friend cannot file a suit against that another friend, because there is no intention between the parties to create a legal relationship. And so such social relation, domestic relation will not recognize under the contract. And so for the formation of contract, the parties must have in their mind that they are coming together for the that particular agreement for a creation of a legal bound or legal relationship in between each other. Next, third essential hai, lawful consideration. Section 2D hai, which says that when at the desire of the promisor, the promissive or any other person does or abstain from doing, done or abstain from doing, promises to do or abstains from doing something, such act or abstinence or promise is called a consideration for the promise. So consideration is nothing but the something in return, and in that both the parties, they are expected that in turn of their promise some benefit they should get out of that transaction. And so it is a quid pro quo. On that basis there is a formation of that particular agreement. And so it is a nothing but the desire of the promisor, that promisee should do something, or promisee may have already done something, or promisee supposed to in future do something. So it also constitute a very valid or the very important element of a valid contract. There is a general rule that agreement without consideration is always a void agreement, but there are certain exceptions to this rule also. Agreement made with natural love and affection, time bar debt, past voluntary services, these are the some exceptions to this particular general rule. Not necessary that consideration must be adequate. So adequacy is not a criteria for the valid consideration or lawful consideration. These are the some points you have to remember in regards with the lawful consideration. Next essential, that is the fourth one, competent parties. Now here in section 11 of the act, it defines that who are competent to the contract. Every person who is not a minor according to the law to which he is subject, and who is not disqualified from contracting, and who is of sound mind, can be entered into a contract. So there are three points. The person must be, or person must not be a minor person. The person should not be disqualified from contracting, and the person who is of sound mind, they can enter into a contract. And so there is an application of Indian Majority Act, which decides the age of majority, that is 18 years. And in case there is appointment of guardian, then the age of majority will be considered as a 21 years of age. The person who is not disqualified from contracting, say for example insolvent person, so insolvent person by law itself disqualified, and so that person also will not be considered as a competent person to enter into a contract. And the person who is of a sound mind, the person who can understand the rationality of the transaction, who can with the mature enough understand the effect or the cause of the transaction, these persons are considered as a competent parties to enter into a contract. You can refer the miners agreement, and for that the Mohri Bibi versus Dharmadas Ghosh, a landmark judgment in regards with the this particular point. Next, that is I think fifth point, free consent. Section 14 define karta hai what is free consent. Consent is nothing but when two parties, they are agreeing on the same particular thing in a same sense, then we can say they both are giving a consent to that transaction. Now when we can say there is a free consent as per Indian Contract Act, so section 14 says that free consent is a consent which is free from coercion, undue influence, misrepresentation, fraud or mistake. And so if a consent is not induced by these five factors, that is coercion, undue influence, misrepresentation, fraud, mistake, then you can say ki there is a free consent. So section 14 jo hai ye panch factors batata hai, and ye panch factors ko individually aapko learn karna hai. So what is coercion, what is undue influence, what is misrepresentation, fraud, mistake, all these five factors you have to understand to understand the free consent. as a very essential for a valid contract. Lawful object and lawful consideration. Section 23 of the Indian Contract Act states that what consideration an object amounts to lawful. The consideration or object of an agreement is considered as a lawful unless it is forbidden by any law, is of such a nature that if permitted it would violate the provisions of any law, is fraudulent or involves or implies injury to another person or property, or the court consider it as a immoral or opposed to public policy. So these are the very points we have to remember if we are understanding the agreement is made for a lawful object and lawful consideration. So aapka agreement aisa hona chahiye jo ki law ne usko prohibit nahi karna chahiye, uska nature aisa hona chahiye ki jo kisi dusre law ki koi bhi provisions ko violate nahi karta hai. आपका एग्रीमेंट ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि जो फ्रॉडुलेंट हो, या ऐसा एग्रीमेंट जो इन्वॉल्व करता है, इम्प्लाई करता है इंजरी टू एनी अनदर पर्सन और प्रॉपर्टी, या फिर कोर्ट जिसको कंसिडर करता है एज अ इमोरल और अपोज टू पब्लिक पॉलिसी, ये एग्रीमेंट जो है वो वैलिड रिकॉग्नाइज नहीं किए जा सकते. एंड सो सेक्शन 23 ऑल्सो कंसिडर एज अ one of the essential element for the validity of the contract. Last, that is, such agreements should not be expressly declared as a void. So an agreement must not be one of those agreements which have been expressly declared to be void. So agreement done with a mistake of fact of both the parties, agreement without consideration, or ye example understands in a way that they are expressly declared as a void agreements by the Indian Contract Act. So ये कुछ criterias अगर आपका agreement fulfill करता है तो ही वो agreement consider किया जाएगा as a contract. And so for the validity of a contract you have to understand that these at least 7 points should be complied with by your agreement, then and then only such agreements can be considered as a valid contract. And so all contracts are agreement, but all agreements are not contract. Sare hi contract agreement ho sakte hai, but sare agreement contract honge hi aisa hum nahi bol sakte hai, because those agreements which are not proving on these particular basic criterias, then such agreements cannot be considered as a valid contracts. And so for the validity of a contract there must be the compliance of all these basic essential elements of such valid contract. So with this note I am stopping here in this video. Thank you for watching this video. Keep watching the next video or the other videos. Thank you very much. If you like it, please share, subscribe. Thank you very much. Thank you.